personality, dreams, desires, motivations, the arts. All of these are a product of the human mind. One can say that the human mind is astonishing, as it is one of the most influential forces in the universe. Yet behind this feat, it is considered as enigmatic as it struggles to define itself due to its complicated and elusive nature. But regardless of all these, we still try to understand the mechanism and the governing rule behind this thing. And that is where psychology enters. The term psychology is derived from the Greek word psyche and logia, which means to study the soul. However, psychology is more than that. In fact, the definition of psychology has undergone a lot of revision throughout history. Today, psychology is defined as the science of behavior and mental processes. It is not about reading the minds of others. Rather, it aims to ponder big questions in life like, are we truly free or not? What is consciousness? What is more important, nature or nurture? What motivates people and more? Though the term psychology was first coined around the 16th century, early philosophers like Aristotle already tackled different psychological concepts like perception, sensation, thinking, and more. In fact, Aristotle's work called The Anima is considered as the first systematic treatise in psychology. According to his work, the soul is the source of the rational thinking of a man. Fast forward to the 17th century, a person who is known for his cogito ergo sum, René Descartes, proposed the idea of interactive dualism. For him, the mind and the body are two separate entities, which interact with each other to produce conscious experience. For more than a century, psychology was considered as more of a philosophy. However, in the mid-19th century, a German physiologist named Wilhelm Wundt brought psychology into a new era. Wundt was born in a German town of Neckarau outside of Mannheim on August 16, 1832. He studied medicine at the University of Tübingen. However, he realized that being a doctor was not his vocation, so he turns himself into physiology at the University of Berlin. Wundt studied physiology under the guidance of Johannes Müller, also known as the father of experimental physiology. In 1857, he became a lecturer at the University of Heidelberg, and at the same time, he worked as a lab assistant to Hermann Helmholtz. On 1862, Wundt introduced experimental psychology in the book Contributions to the Theory of Sensory Perception. However, he is much more known for his groundbreaking works, Principle of Physiological Psychology, which was published in 1874. In this work, he emphasizes the connection between physiology and psychology. He also asserts that psychology should become a distinct scientific discipline, and with this goal, he opened the very first psychology research laboratory at Leipzig University in 1879. Throughout his teaching career, Wundt attracted a lot of students from different parts of the world. For over a year, more than 17,000 students migrated to Germany to attend his class. Wundt's hard work became a fundamental step in the creation of different schools of thought on psychology, from structuralism, functionalism, psychodynamic, and more. And with this, it is safe to say that Wilhelm Maximilian Wundt is truly the founder of psychology.